Thank you so much for taking the time out and for joining us here today. Let's start with a little introduction from your end.
Hi, as you know, my name is Abhilasha Bora. I'm from Assam. I'm 18 years old and I'm currently pursuing textile designing from NIFT Kannur. I'm a cisgender female. I'm pansexual and I'm polyamorous.
Hi, it is me, Prateek Parme, a 22-year-old biological male, but I identify as gender fluid. And I am a dancer, actor, singer, model, magician, musician, basically everything, except for the fact that no one employs me for the aforementioned designations. Life is good.
Yeah. Hi, everyone. Wish you all a very happy Pride Month. My name is Karthik. I'm a social influencer. And besides that, I'm a blogger as well. I identify myself as gay. And I live in New Delhi. Well, currently I'm working at Max Hospital for the COVID.
What do you think are the struggles you face or in the society?
Mostly, when it comes to me, my number one struggle is straight passing. I think although the society has become more accepting of the LGBTQ community, they have also developed this idea of how gay people should look like or who they should date. And if I don't fit in that box, if I don't look gay enough, and if I start dating a cis heterosexual male, they will literally dismiss my sexuality. So yeah, For a long time, I used to, you know, keep quiet, not speak up for it. But then now I voice it. I literally do, like, I try to educate them. And yeah, from less, from none to some few people now, they are like willing to learn, willing to accept. Coming out to my parents and friends, it wasn't hard. You know, the people who love you will love you no matter what. But the outer world, obviously, coming out, you know, virtually to my audience, you know, Instagram audience and everyone, it was harsh. It's still harsh. We still get threats, you know. Demeaning comments, but still, I'm strong. I know who I am now. I have loving audience as well, friends and family. So yeah, it's fine now.
First of all, whenever someone is born who is stereotypically different and does not fit into the societal norms, they've been looked at differently. They've been made feel that they are different. Here's what I have to say. Whenever we are born, no one of us is born with the exact same traits. We are all different. But what they term is like, we are extremely different. We're from a different world, and that's wrong. So the first thing will be injustice. That's the first thing. The second thing I would like to point out is acceptance. Whenever it comes to acceptance, yeah, the societal acceptance is a whole different concept. But for LGBT queer folks, accepting oneself is a huge struggle in itself. Many people have internalized homophobia, they have gender dysphoria and physical dysphoria, so many other things, because this society is toxic. Hate is so prevalent, injustice is so prevalent. People think that love and justice is something which is rare and not taken seriously. The next thing I would like to point out is existence. The whole existence of a person belonging to the LGBTQIA community who is bold and vocal about their thoughts are always treated very differently. And that is unfair. The last thing I would like to point out is the fact that they can be disowned by families. They can be disowned by their friends. In fact, in case you didn't know, the LGBTQIA folks, according to a research in USA, are 3 times more likely to commit a suicide compared to the cisgender or heterosexual population here. But imagine if that's the rate in USA, what would be the rate in India? People are disowned here. People are disowned here by their own families, their friends, just for being gay or whatever they are. And that's totally unfair.
Well, coming out for me wasn't easy because I grew up in a homophobic family and I didn't come out. I had to come out. I had to, because someone from my Instagram account sent my screenshots of my Pride Month, you know, dress to my parents. And then they questioned me, ki, is it you? Why are you dressed like this? Like, I was dressed in an androgynous way. And that way, like, my parents were asking, ki, why are you wearing clothes like this? And all that. And they questioned me a lot at that time. It was in the month of 2020. Last year only I came out. So last year, in 2019, when the Pride Month was conducted, in the month of November, And then in January, they received a screenshot. So in January, it was a pretty difficult month for me. Then somewhere this conversation went down. That time I denied to them that I'm not. It's just I support them because I didn't have the courage at that time to open up. But then when I started uploading Pride Month, you know, posts on, first of all, I uploaded about the Stonewall riots that occurred in Greenwich Village, which was a remarkable date on 27th June in the history of LGBTQ community. Then I also posted about the Orlando incident. I'll be talking about them in the struggle part. And then I also posted about the flower movement, flower power movement. So they were asking me that, why are you dressed like this? Why are you wearing makeup and all? So then I had to come out and it wasn't good. But for some other people, I've heard that the parents are very accepting and they still, you know, have love for them because no matter what, they are their children. So for me, it hasn't been good, but I hope in the coming generation with the passing laws and all, for the gay community, for the trans community, for everyone, that we get more accepted by the society, because acceptance is what means to us a lot, because being recognized and making it, you know, not unnatural, but somewhere natural and somewhere that it exists in society. It's not like we don't exist. It's just some of us are hidden because of the societal pressures. Regarding the society, like in my college life, it was pretty good because my friends were very like in my class. I came out to two of my best friends, Varun and Suti. I think they're in this live only.
Yeah, they are.
And they must be viewing it. So it was like I was on my last brain cell. Like, should I tell them? Should I not tell them? Should I tell them? Should I not tell them? Then I referred to them as Jim, the guy from Big Bang Theory. I think Jim Parsons is his name. So I referred his name. Like he and I, we both are on the same boat. So are you happy with this? So then they were like, okay, we are getting closer to you. What are you trying to say? And then I had to open and they were very friendly. And even my whole class, I'm not going to lie, my whole class was very friendly and very accepting towards me, which was such a big thing for me because in my school time, I have been mocked plenty number of times and somewhere I have been thrown things at me for myself. So school time, like you cannot, you know, people are very immature at that time. They don't have an idea about the various kind of people that exist in a society. They don't know what gay means. Even if they mean, they see it as something which is very funny and comedy to mock at. But then when you go in college, you develop a kind of, you know, maturity in you and you understand, okay, these people exist and we should respect them for who they are and be more accepting. So it was very good. Even in my job right now, somewhere some people still have an idea about me, and then I will be like trying to open up one day to them as well. So because the environment is very friendly as well in my job place. So I hope that even they accept me for who I am.
Do you guys see any positive change around you? Positive things coming up ahead?
Yes, positivity. There is a lot of positivity. And when I talk about positivity, it comes with a change in time. So if we see statistically, people from the older generations, they don't tend to understand what LGBTQIA+ is. And that is a huge problem. And I cannot even blame them. They're from a whole different generation and they have whole different thoughts and traditions in their minds. But as time has progressed, we can see that people who are upcoming now, people who are growing now, the teenagers, the young adults, they are pretty much accepting of LGBTQIA+, and they have a pretty much idea. So that's one of the positive things. And secondly, there are many NGOs coming out. There are many, you know, queer communities coming out which help each other in times of need. That's the second positive note I would like to say. And the third positive thing that I would like to point out is people are getting more vocal. Each and every person belonging to the LGBTQIA+ community is so vocal about everything. They love themselves to the fullest extent, and that is changing quite every spectrum for everyone in LGBTQIA community. In fact, people ask me, who is your biggest inspiration in the LGBTQIA community? I would like to say that everyone, whoever is here, everyone who is a part of the LGBTQIA+ community is an inspiration to me, because they have been doing amazing job. They've been tackling such serious issues and surviving in this harsh world. So thank you so much to everyone from LGBTQIA+ community.
So what do you think, you know, the changes that can come and how social media can become like a very huge platform to put this to a good use?
Obviously, statistically, as you said, the younger people are way more vocal about it. And I think it's because, you know, being in a heteronormative society, it's hard. It's hard to unlearn things which you have been learning from years. But be it old or young, it takes a lot to unlearn things. And seeing people inside the society or outside the community, that they are raising voices, you know, they're supporting. They're, like, it takes a lot because the amount of hate you get is way more than the amount of support you get. So, yeah, that's a lot.
So, as gay people, we get to find our own chosen family in the long run of our lives. And I found my family there as well. And I came out in the month, on my Instagram account, I came out in the month of 2018. And the reaction that I got from people was very positive. And I was very happy that they were accepting me. And I even got a lot of, you know, recognition from my, my tuition mates. Yeah. I used, like, in my school times and, I used to go to tuition and all. And then even my friends from there, they, you know, started texting me, oh, hey, we read your story on Official Humans of Bombay. We are so happy for you that you came out, and so much more power to you and love to you. And that meant a lot to me that people who, like, in my past, they are, like, getting to know my story and everything. And it was such a very positive, it was a very positive thing. And even people from my school, like, they were also texting me, Karthik, they had read about you. And some were like, oh, okay, is it you? And some of them had a negative reaction, but most of them had a very positive reaction, which was a very, you know, enlightening for me, that I felt so happy that we are school friends who had 90% of, you know, they were confused about me. They used to even ask me, but that time I used to deny every time. But then social media played a very, very, very good role. And then even I did few sponsorships with some of the pages as well on my account. And even still, I'll be doing it with few more pages. And then talking about the positive change in the society, yes, there has been a positive change because one of my school friends, his name is Arjun. He told me that when in his DU college, people used to conduct a lot of pride marches, which is a very positive thing that people in college, like the college that I was in, I'm not going to name it now, but that was apolitical. So we had talked to our dean and all about, you know, officializing the meeting of queer people from our college. But then they said that, no, we won't be doing it at all. But in Delhi University, I personally have made a lot of pride marches in Delhi as well with few of my queer mates. And the amount of love that people have showed, it was very overwhelming. So that to know that people in like this generation, the coming generation, which is very accepting, that will be the future generation we should be more focusing on. Because the conventional and the previous generation, they are not going to get. Few of them are going to get, but not all of them. So the coming generation means a lot to us. And if this generation accepts, then I'm sure there will be a very positive future ahead for us.
So what are your final thoughts on, you know, what is the message you want to put out to the world?
Okay, so what happened to all those who don't know, on 12th June, in the month of 2016, in Orlando, there is a gay club that goes by the name of Pulse. What happened at around post 12 o'clock, around 2 or 3, what happened, there was a security guard named Omar Mati. He had shot at least 49 people from the community, because of just being from the community. I mean, so much of hatred and so much of homophobia it was. And like, people were shocked that how can, you know, like, it's not safe. You are going to a club, you're someone's brother, you're someone's sister, you're someone's, like, your child. And that person, when you hear next to that, they're dead just because of being themselves. That is a very traumatizing, you know, thing to get recover from. And this happened in 2016, and it led to a lot of awareness among the community that people really got to know about, okay, so this has happened. And then there was a lot of, you know, Pride parades in Orlando. And then there was Stonewall riots that happened on the date of 27th June 1969 in Greenwich Village, New York City. So what had happened was that there was another, you know, club where Stonewall riots. And then what happened, people were, you know, they were again fired for being themselves. So this has, you know, this is the reason why June is considered to be a Pride month, because of these reasons that a lot of, you know, we have a history from the community about incidents happening to the people for just being themselves and creating so much of hatred towards people, killing them on a mass shooting. Bill Clinton, yeah, he made June as the Pride Month for gay and lesbians. But then Barack Obama extended this Pride Month, June, to LGBT, which was a very, you know, great thing for people to feel happy. And it's not something that June should only be the Pride Month for everyone. Like every month, every year, we should be celebrating it. June is considered just a month of in the history of the queer community that something very bad happened. And yeah, in the future generation, I just hope there's love for everyone and acceptance from every parent to their kid.
Riot actually began on 28th June. That's why it is celebrated as the day globally for International Pride. The incident, you know, that, you know, the killing of gay in the gay bar at Stonewall, and it happened in 27, but the riot actually started in the early morning of 28th June. So thank you so much, Jeeva, for making me the diva I'm supposed to be. You know, I'm a Jeeva diva. And last but not the least, if there is anyone from LGBTQIA+ community watching this, I would like to tell you this thing. What others think of you doesn't matter. What you think about yourself definitely does. This is something my grandmother has taught me since a very early age. And I keep it engraved in my heart. And you should too. And if there is any homophobe watching this, here's a message for you. Listen, it's okay to be illiterate. It's okay to not know things. But it's not okay to harm someone physically, mentally, or spiritually just because they are who they are and they're not scared to show what they are from inside and out. And last but not the least, happy Pride Month.
My last words will be gender and sexuality are a very, very, very vast terms. And I think the day when people find out those thoughts, you know, that's the day that they feel conflicted. So yeah, more and more people should be flexible about it and should know that these are vast and not finite.